I remain Leo Ogor, representing the Isoko Federal Constituency. Mr. Speaker, my colleagues, I'm from Delta State. Let me first and foremost thank the mover and author of this motion for bringing up a very, very fundamental issue that borders also on what I probably would want to call the right of the Nigerian citizens, a fundamental right which is not a privilege. Mr. Speaker, my colleagues, I believe it is important we call a spade a spade. I've had arguments where some are saying that INEC probably lacks the capacity, the staff capacity to carry out such a function. Let me probably remind those that have such a mindset that that is the law. It is the law of our land. It is the right of the citizens of this country. There is no local government headquarters in this nation that INEC does not have an office. There are people that have been paid on a daily basis, on a monthly basis, with taxpayers' money. It is not every day that somebody turns 18. And this is what the law says. It says very, very clear here that it is a continuous exercise. We must try as much as we can to avoid this stopgap approach, this cut and nail approach where we are getting to election, then all of a sudden everybody will start being, you know, start this rush to register people. I think it is a very, very wrong approach. Registration is a daily affair. That is why those INEC officers go to the office. Why are they being paid if they cannot carry out this specific function? There is a lot of wisdom in saying that as soon as you turn 18, you should be registered. We now have to wait and probably about 3 months or 4, 5 months to election. You will just go and pack youth corpus and start another registration exercise. I think that is very, very wrong. This is not something we should encourage. INEC must act within the confines of the law. And the law stipulates very clearly the basis of which a human being, a Nigerian citizen, can vote. That continuous registration exercise is what the Act recognizes. So I believe, Mr. Speaker, my colleagues, that the House Committee must wake up to its responsibility. The prayers of this particular motion is very, very straightforward. Mandate the Committee on Electoral and Political Party Matters to investigate the non-compliance of INEC with the provisions of the Electoral Act on continuous voters' registration. I raised this issue yesterday, and I think it is very, very important because the voters' registration is the basis. It is the fundamentals in the Electoral Act of which any human being, mostly Nigerian citizens, can vote. So to avoid unnecessary disenfranchisement, it becomes important that this very, very important issue is addressed by the committee, because we don't want to wait till we get to 2019 and all of a sudden we start rushing to carry out this whole exercise. I believe that a stitch in time saves nine, and we should encourage and support this motion so that we make sure that every Nigerian citizen that wants to vote is registered and given the opportunity to vote. So I support this motion.